easy go.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to Vroom and Boom. Today we are trying out something new. We've got a little debate going on. So we've had these brake pads in the garage for a while, and we got a little debate here of what caliber of a gun will go through a brake pad. And we'll show you what we're shooting here. Danny, if you want to go over the calibers with them and let them see that.
Sure. So starting off, we're going to use my 12 gauge. I've got a little 88 kicking around right there. We're just going to use birdshot, just because of what I got on hand, and I was going to say that's definitely not going through. We're going to step up to 22mm mini mag, a little small bullet, probably my Ruger 10-22. Again, definitely not going through. 380, fired out of my DD380, definitely not going through. 9mm, the real Lord's caliber, fired out of Gavin's. What is that? That's your Spitty Widow. And then we're gonna have 40 fired out of my baby. This one might go through just because of PFM. If y'all don't know what that means, look it up. Then we're gonna step up to the Lord's caliber. This old boomer bullet here, 45. Definitely not going through. And then now is when it's gonna get. This is when the debate gets heated, right? This is a 223. We're going to fire it out of a Diamondback AR-15. Really sweet gun. I don't think it's going through. I think it'll notch it. I think it'll put a nice dish in it, but it ain't going through. And then just for overkill, 300 Winchester Magnum. It's going right through. I mean, it's like a hot knife through butter. This baby's going to go through and then cut through a tree behind it. This is going. Let's see.
All right, guys, we'll show you what we got rigged up here. Like I said, these are just normal old brake pads. We just got them taped up here, and we're gonna start off with the 12 gauge birdshot.
Yes, sir.
Birdshot, and let's see what happens.
Let her rip, tater chip.
Now we're shooting at about 6 yards.
Yeah.
Which is gonna be your average span of a getting a gunfight. So, like I said, we're basing this off can it be body armor. So.
And if it'll stop, if it stops at 223. I'm going to have a project in the future. So if you're doing a brake change and you live in Western North Carolina and you wind up with some extra brake pads you got to throw away, we'll come get them, maybe, if this works.
All right, range hot.
Range hot, new ears on.
Okay. All
right.
Bird shot, 12 gauge.
Did not go through.
See what kind of damage
no way
we got.
In hell this went through.
Oh, it kind of dinged it. Oh,
that's the ceramic on it.
Yeah. Well, it's not ceramic, but that's the actual brake side. Okay. Well, now let's hit it with a 22. Still not going through.
All right. So next caliber we're using is the Danny's beautiful wood grain Ruger 10-22, and we're using CCI mini mag. So see if we can hit it.
Yeah.
Little indention. Let's go bigger.
Let's see what we got.
Diamondback 380.
Just too accurate.
Yeah.
Just too deadly with this gun. Really the issue.
Right shot.
Oh.
Try it again.
Let's see.
I thought you hit it the first time. I think it's just that
I'm
fence post.
I'm pretty sure it did.
Oh, God. Okay, I hit right above that.
Yeah.
No, ignore this. Ignore this. That's the hit. Barely dented it. Like I figured, 380 ain't doing nothing. Oh, and it hit over here, too, and it kind of bent it some.
No, yeah, it did right there.
Yeah, barely put a dent. All right, let's take it up a notch. You going to shoot the 9mm?
Yep.
Do it.
30. All right, so next we're doing the Smith & Wesson SD9. VE, and see if we can hit it with this.
Is it going through? Yeah, definitely hit. Ha! Oh, yeah.
So put a dent in the whole steel. Just put a good little dent in it.
Compared to the 380.
It's a little deeper.
Yeah. Definitely deeper than the 380. Still.
Gotta go bigger.
It'd still save your life.
Yeah.
So far we're winning against handguns.
All right, up next is my CZ75 chambered in 40 Smitty Wetto. I don't really think it'll go through, but I hope it does just because of my love of this gun. Let's see.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Check that out. A little high, but she smacked it. No. Didn't.
Not even a dent.
Yeah, I think it did less than the 9mm. Bigger impact, but less of a dent. All right, let's move on.
All right, so next up, we got the car, CW45. We'll try to hit it with this. Not a good shot on this gun, so don't judge me.
Believe that was a hit.
It was a hit.
Flew off. Let's find the right one now. No, not that one. I think it's this one over here.
Yeah. Oh, I hit the hole again.
Did you hit the hole again?
Yeah.
Gavin. No, well, I mean, you hit right here.
So yeah.
That'll count.
It knocked the hole out.
That's not even as good as the 9 or the 40.
No.
No. No chance.
We're going up in caliber, but going down in damage.
Wow. What are we going to shoot next, buddy?
What is next?
I believe we've maxed out our pistols here.
Ah.
Let's step up to the main event.
Yeah.
Comment below. Will a 223 go through a brake pad? We'll find out.
All right, so now we got to step it up to a Ralph around. So Danny, tell me what you're going to be shooting there.
This is the main event, boys and girls. It's the DB15. Right now we've got 223 rounds in it. We're going to see if it'll go through. So what do you guys think? You think a brake pad will stop a 223? Find out.
Still hitting post.
Goddamn. Aim way high on this. Oh. All right. Oh, might have taken a couple of rounds. We gotta sight this rifle in. Ah. But let's see. I was hitting kind of high.
Okay. Yeah, we hit it in the tape there. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Right through three times. Oh man.
Like, right through that pad.
Like butter. Like it's nothing.
Look, I can see you through it. But now we're gonna try out our, we're gonna try the 300 Winback. You wanna stack a couple? Let's stack a couple.
How many? Don't mind the background noise, we've got the drone playing. So we found out 223 goes right through it like it's nothing really.
But
how many can it go through? So how many have we got here, Danny?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. To be fair, they're not all the same. They don't all have the same wear on them. But
no, like that one out there is not even half.
This is just for funsies.
The rest of them are pretty low. But let's see.
We're gonna see how far.
See what a 300 Win Mag will do to it.
Yeah.
How many will go through?
I think it'll go through 3.
Comment down below how many you think, and we'll.
I think it's gonna go through 3.
3? I'm gonna say 4.
You say 4? What do you guys think?
Oh.
We've got the Remington Model 700, 300 chamber and 300 Win Mag. 5?
5, yeah.
5 brake pads. Let's see what it'll do.
Yeah. Check that out.
You recording?
Yeah.
That thing kicks like a mother. I'm pretty sure I hit it pretty dead on.
Oh, yeah.
Or did I hit this?
No. You hit it right here.
Did I?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Let's try to keep these together.
Here. Just cut it.
Oh, there you go. I don't want these to fall apart, so I want to see how many we went through. Yeah. Let's take these over to the truck and figure it out.
Yeah. How many?
Oh, we got brake stuff everywhere. So we definitely went through the first one.
Oh yeah, I can see the shot.
Can you see around in there?
Oh, look at there. So we went through two.
Ooh, somebody was right. Were you right? Oh yeah. There's the bullet.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Wow, look at that hole.
So now we know, if you want to make body armor to stop a 300 Win Mag, and these are just like the little ones. The two little plates, the two little brake pads will do the trick. I bet two of these would easily stop a 223.
Oh, easily.
Now we know.
All right, Danny, why don't we talk about what we figured out today?
So moral of the story here, I think, is that brake pads don't make great body armor if somebody's shooting at you with a big gun. You could use it to stop pistol rounds. That worked all day long. But yeah, if you were like me and correctly guessed the brake pad would not stop a 223, then congratulations on that, guys.
Show them that brake pad right there. I don't know if we ever got a close-up on
that. Oh, yeah. So this was the one that Gavin shot with his 300 Win Mag, that M24 freaking sniper rifle he's got. And it stopped it. I mean, it caught it. It put a hole, right? But it caught the round right there. These are the little bitty baby ones.
And there's fragments, yeah, all in it.
All kinds of. Here's a big chunk of the bullet there. But I mean, if you were making like some, you know, like Fallout style ghetto body armor, and you had a bunch of brake pads, maybe you're a mechanic and you just wanted to like weld them together or something for all over your torso. Oh, you could make chainmail. But yeah, with brake pads. We might do that.
I would do it like the old days and just weld a bunch of them together and throw a chain around them and make a back plate too.
Yeah. Do that.
Yeah.
All right. So.
And then we'll get to 22 and go here and shoot each other.
Bing, bing. It'll be like paintball.
Yeah.
But don't do that, kids.
No.
Don't do that.
No.
Somebody will die and then me and Gavin will probably go to jail. So yeah, you got anything to say about it, man?
No, you went over every bit of it. Like I said, it went up to a 223 round. That was all for it. And it looked like to me the higher or the bigger of a bullet we went to, the less damage it does.
Well, what I think we learned here or solidified is that 9mm full metal jacket is a pretty decent penetrator. Even though it didn't go through, it notched it out a lot better than those heavier bullets, the 40 and the 45.
I might have to make another video on it and try like critical defense rounds, hollow points, see what they do, yeah, to it. You know, get away from the ballpoint ammo and hit it with some hollow points and see what the damage difference is.
Hollow points are going to do a lot less.
Yeah,
I think.
Because the bullet's going to break quicker.
Yeah.
So, well, there you go.
Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Like and subscribe. And we'll see you next time. If you've been wondering, just